Six car of Jason Mount, definitely mounting his charge for a pole start for the feature coming up a little bit later for the Thunder Division. White flag will wave next time by. He's holding off the tough challenges of the 112 of Billy Asbury, who has multiple feature wins this season in the Thunder Division here at Wartburg Speedway. White lap, one lap to go for the six of Jason Mount. A great side-by-side battle for that third spot between the 20 of Jericho Stevens and the 64 of Bo Willis. So it'll be Jason Mount, your victor, the 112 of Billy Asbury in second, and the 20 of Jericho Stevens rounding out your top three.
Mackenzie Rod and the 42 of John Sims. Between Tiff Chambers, Robert Russell. Contact between the 22 of McKenzie Ryan and the 19 of Tiff Chambers. That's going to take out second through fourth, the whole back and field. Robert Russell all out by himself. Takes the lead going down the backstretch. Tiff Chambers in second, McKenzie Wine third, John Sims in fourth. Racers coming off at turn number four to complete lap number one. One lap complete, five laps to go. The battle is on for second between the 19 and the 22. McKenzie Wine secures that position going down the backstretch. She'll now move into position number two. Robert Russell, your leader, coming off of turn number four. McKenzie Wine second, Tiff Chambers third, John Sims in fourth. Two laps in, four laps to go as we set the outside roll for the Thunder feature coming up a little later on tonight. Reached the halfway point in the race. Robert Russell continues to lead. The 22 of McKenzie White in second. Tiff Chambers and John Sims now battle for third. John Sims pulls the outside, now the inside. Coming out of turn number two, down the backstretch. The 42 of the 19 side by side. Russell continues to lead as we complete lap number four. Turn three, flagman Ricky Lau with the white flag in hand. He's going to show it to the 1R of Robert Russell as he comes out of turn number four. McKenzie White in second, Tiff Chambers third, John Sims will cross the line in fourth. Checkered flag coming out next time by. We're determining the outside row for the 300 to win from the feature coming up tonight. Here they go, into three, out of four. Checkered flag is going to wave for the 1R machine of Robert Russell. McKenzie White will finish in second. Then the battle's still on for third between the 19 of Tiff Chambers, the 42 of John Sims out of turn number four, their nose to tail. Tiff Chambers will finish third. John Sims will finish fourth. Robert Russell will start on the outside pole tonight in the Thunder Division feature coming up a little later on in the program.
Two cars scheduled for heat race number one. Scratch from the starting line. As far as Trent, car number 101, not on Speedway. Neither is the Kane Hickman car, who had trouble in the hot lap session earlier tonight. And so now we are down to eight cars. Two of these drivers will either have to go to a provisional or go to the house for the remainder of the evening, as our OK sign has been given. It's eight laps around, eight cars. We're taking six of them to determine the inside starting lineup from rows 6 through 11, and it's green flag time here at the Gap. Heat race number one is underway. David Payne trying to get that inside lane, but Riley Hickman's going to use that outside line and get run off the hill in turn number two. David Payne right with him as they look down off a corner number four. David Payne made a run down low. Riley Hickman off the hill. He'll take lap number one. Lap number two underway. David Payne still right there with him. Ben Watkins in third. Mark Vineyard in the fourth position. Ryan King in that 30 car. Here's the battle for the transfer. that final spot on the speedway between Bobby Mays and Steve Smith coming out of turn number three. They'll enter turn four halfway next time. Riley Hickman's, Hickman's manufacturing car number 1H is off, or excuse me, the R1 is off of the back straightaway, entering turns three and four, and we're halfway down, four remaining. Heat race number two, be ready when they're off of turn number two. Riley Hickman exits turn number two. Ben Watkins will swing it wide, exiting the backstretch entrance of turn number three. The points leader in third, Vineyard is fourth, and Steve Smith, the car that's in the field so far. Bobby Mays trying to run him down with two to go next time by. David Payne, right, able to stay with the leader, Riley Hickman, as they exit turn number one this time. It'll be the white flag and a one-lap rag next time by. Ben Watkins, that car a bit loose as the back end wants to get away from him over there exiting turn number one. As he's got it all the way against the wall, it's going to be one to go for Riley Hickman. Hickman gasses it up down the back straightaway. The checkered flag will come down this time by, and the heat race number one is over. Riley Hickman wins over David Payne. Ben Watkins, a battle for fourth off of car number four. It'll be Mark Vineyard. Then it'll be the 30 car, Brian King. And a battle to the line. Steve Smith outdueling Bobby Mays for that final spot on the field. Car number three will finish in sixth. Bobby Mays to seventh. Travis Greer rounding out the field in heat race number one. Right after heat race number two, it's going to be a fast intermission race, fans. It'll be National Anthem, it'll be Prayer, and it'll be Carolina Clash. Screven, Georgia, in Sylvania County, down there to Red Diffins Racetrack for race number six on the season before we go back to Carolina for Cherokee Speedway's May 9th event, race number seven on the season. Take a week off before we head back up here to close out the spring season of the Carolina Clash 2015 campaign here with the final race of the spring season at the Gap, May the 23rd. Take a week off, head to Fayetteville, North Carolina for the first week of June, and then the Lawrence County Shrine Race will close out the first half of the year on Tuesday night, June the 9th. We're going green next time. This time, all right, we're underway. They brought him all the way out of the corner, and it's Doug Sanders, car number 42, gasses up and gone down the back straightaway. Kyle Pierce, Dennis Franklin, he digs down to the bottom. That two car up off the corner, go to turn number one. Doug Sanders leads lap one. Kyle Pierce working the high line. He's got the black stripe going for him in the 281. He'll sling it high, but here comes Rambo to the bottom. Kyle Pierce going to try to get back on the outside of him, and it was a squeeze play at the start-finish line. Rambo goes to second. Kyle Pierce in third. Aaron Ridley in fourth. It's Kenny Collins and Dale McDowell rounding out the top six. Coming, oh, big car. Licked off of turn number four. Sparks flew. We had a car hard in the concrete. I don't know if it was Kyle Pierce or Aaron Ridley. About the same time they exited the corner, it was a big contact with the concrete. We're halfway home. Four to go. And Doug Sanders leading the points champion. Dennis Franklin, three wide racing. Aaron Ridley, Kenny Collins, Dale McDowell off of turn number two. Here they come again. Collins going to try to thread the needle. He looks out of four. They go side by side at the start-finish line. That is the race for the top six, the transfer. Roger Best outside. Anthony Sanders and Kevin Wilson potentially going to provisionals. Here we come with two to go. White flag and a one-lap rag. Next time by for Nick Sanders. Dale McDowell, good battle over Aaron Ridley off of turn number two. The car that hit the wall in qualifying. He's got the car rebounded. He's up to fourth and at 17. Looks up at that time by, it may have been Kyle Pierce that smacked the wall coming out turn number four a moment ago, but Doug Sanders, he's going to win heat race number two. He'll start from the outside of row number six. Rambo will start from the outside of row number seven. It'll be Kyle Pierce in row eight, Dale McDowell from row nine, Aaron Ridley row 10, Kenny Collins in row 11, and provisional starters most likely will be those two cars going into turn number one and number two. We'll have to check our running order to make sure. But Anthony Sanders and Kevin Wilson most likely will qualify for those provisional starting spots. So congratulations, Doug Sanders. He picks up very valuable bonus points for winning the Safety Clean Heat Race number two. And he...
turn one to your park in if we can. We've got someone stuck over there. If we can get somebody to go over there and help them out. Turn one, maybe we've got a spectator stuck in the mud. We can get some of you guys to run over there and help get that one out, please. Nine cars in the field tonight. Nine cars in the field. Our Thunder Division, as they go off tonight, 20 laps. Running for $300 to win tonight in the Thunder Division. There's the green we are racing. Caution flag comes out on the track. Caution flag is out on the track. Caution on the track, caution on the track. Big old bumper laying up there in turn number one. Everybody's trying to avoid that. Track crew will get out. 15 laps are in the books right now, ladies and gentlemen, as they continue on their way. Caution's on the racetrack. Caution on the racetrack comes out on the 22 car. NSPN coming out of turn number. Flag being displayed for Billy Asbury. Bullets of Dragways coming out of turn number 3 and 4. Who's going to be your winner? It will be Billy Asbury. Mel will finish second. Bo Willis will finish in that third spot, followed by Bucky Nats. So it will be Billy Asbury, your winner, here in the Thunder Division tonight. 20 laps. And folks, we hope you've enjoyed it here tonight as we're going to send it back down trackside to Dustin Bonham. And again, as you leave.
Machine, Billy Asbury!
He's got a picture of that driving up on the other car.
Yeah. All right, Billy, as you make your way over here, you made 2 feature wins in a row, but you got a big one tonight when you picked up the $300 to win, bro.
I appreciate it. I want to thank God and my family and Roger Smith's family. Thank you.
All right, race fans, let him hear you one more time. The driver of the 112, Asbury. Race fans, we do hope that you have a safe trip home. Thank you so much for being a part of the big fireworks on the Mountain 40. On behalf of track owner Mike Kitchell, race director Brad Bird. Race fans, let's hear it for all the staff. They said we were crazy for even trying it. Let's hear it for all the staff at Wartburg Speedway that got in every lap of the fireworks on the Mountain 40 tonight. Race fans, have a safe trip home. We'll see you back here next Saturday night. For track owner Mike Kitchell, for race director Brad Bird, for Keith Adcock helping me in the tower, this is your announcer, Dustin Bonham, saying good night and God bless.
The beautiful four-wide salute. Race fans, I encourage you at this time to come to your feet with cameras in hand. Ready to record this beautiful sight of 25 Super Late Model race cars pacing the way. They're standing for you, and they're waving at you. Craig, I'll tell you, there's no better sight in all of racing than to see those cars stacked up four deep like that.
I'll tell you what, I love to see a crowd like this turn out on a Saturday night, and I love to see a full field of cars.
Race director Rick Ellison giving the orders of where the fire line is over here exiting turn number one. We should get one to go. You see the scoreboard lit up with the first five cars? That should be changing throughout the course of the evening. And that lap count will watch it click up 50 times as we search for that checkered flag. Kyle Pierce having some issues on car number 281. He is going to tag on to the rear of the field, giving up his 16th place starting position. Green flag is going to fly the next time by. We've talked enough. We've done all the stuff that we can do to get you ready for this opening spectacle of motors, this opening spectacle of speed coming off of corner number four. Spring Thaw 2015 is officially underway. Give them green! Do it again. Perhaps a little bit of Tom and Jerry going on there. And I always watched old Spike, the Bulldog. Spike might be sitting in row two with that iron pike. Ready to go! Green flag is out of the gap. They could take off. Early lead down the back straightaway. Come on, boys. Let's get up through the corner. Number four, Ray Cook leads lap one. McIntosh settling into second channel. We're now into third. Here comes Stacy Bowles up in the fourth position. Matt McCarter, Ferguson in trouble. He's backpedaling the 22 car. Maybe saving it to come alive later on as they are just everywhere around turns one and two and three and four. They could be quickly closing in on the back field. Kyle Pierce, the 21, still struggling. Having problems after qualifying. So here we go, three up on the board. It is Ray Cook out in front. One car slowing down the first straightaway. It's Mark Vineyard in the four. Kyle Pierce is going to bring it in on pit road, 281. Down pit road, the four car is also slowing down the back straightaway. Ray Cook out in front, but they are swarming. With about 14 on back, they're battling for position. Doug Sanders, David Payne, there's Ben Watkins. As the leader starts to close in on the tail end of Bobby Mays' car. Caution on the speedway. One car slowing down, exiting turn number four. Yellow is out. Have to see that car come off the banking over here to get a number. It's come to a stop on the speedway. We'll try to get a look at who that is. The firing line will be the middle of three and four, just about where the Pizza Plus sign is. That's about where the firing line is. Those guys can go from that point all the way around to the exit of turn number four. Firing up this time by. Should get the okay sign. Yep, the caution lights have gone out around the speedway, and we are racing next time by on lap number four. And there you have it. Green flag is out. We're back underway at the gap. Second spot. McIntosh going to give him a little nudge going down the back straightaway. Here comes Billy Oval Jr. down to the bottom. We've got a battle for third coming off of turn number four. But the Tar Heel Tiger, he's got the high neck working long and strong. each other hard over in turn number three. Rambo's car pushed high off of turn number four. We're 10 down. 40 to go. Resort back to 20, five shy of the halfway mark.
Plus in the middle of the pack, but I tell you what, this race between Ray Cook and Chad Ogle is going to be something that's going to be close to watch tonight. Plus,
May the 2nd, and the Clash will be back in town May the 23rd. It'll be our third of five stops in the 2015 Border Wars campaign. This is the OK sign, 20 complete, 30 to go, five to halfway. So it's been Ray Cook flag to flag, but it has not been easy working in this lap traffic, fending off Ogle, getting picked off, Ogle taking the lead momentarily, Cook getting it back. And is Donald McIntosh holding anything? Is he saving something for this last, the second half of the field, or the second half of the race? We're going green out of turn four. Now McIntosh jumps to the bottom. He'll clear Chad Ogle for the second spot as Ogle jumps back. It's just a rocket ship up on that outside lane. But Donald McIntosh, he's got it holding his steady off of turn number three. And on the outside, it's Billy Ogle Jr. Look at Dennis Franklin powering underneath of Stacy Bowles. The two car goes to the top five. He tried to bring Vic Hill with him as Bowles' car up on that outside lane. He'll try to get back around Vic Hill as they work off of turns one and two. to the back of the field, and about two more laps around the Speedway, we're starting to see some of that threading the needle again with these front two cars. As there is some good battling going on back in the field, Doug Sanders, Dale McDowell, Mark Douglas. Chad Ogle off the pace, car number 10, slows out of turn number 3, in trouble. So the charge for 2 is going to come short here tonight for the 10 car. So Ogle's on pit road. Trouble has befallen him. Tough, tough break. So McIntosh now in second, Billy Ogle in third, Dennis Franklin in fourth, Big Hill running fifth as we have cleared the halfway point. 40 laps complete this time by 20 to go.
Coming for the lead off the corner. Ray Cook's got a run on the outside.
one-lap rag is falling down on the Tiger. The Tar Heel Saint Ray Cook. Coming off the back straightaway, he's going to be able to pace himself to victory lane. Your winner, Ray Cook. And the goal will be second. Donald McIntosh in third. Vic Hill with a run up to the fourth place position. Stacy Bowles rounding out the top five.
Hugs and congratulations from the whole crew as we try to get a signal up to the tower so I can get word with our race winner. What a hard work you had to pull off in them first 20 laps. That was fun to watch, but I know you were working your butt off over there.
Oh, man, I ain't ashamed for that, but, you know, we just, thanks to the good Lord for blessing us with a great night. Appreciate all the fans coming out, and, you know, I can't thank everybody that helps me, Marshall Green with Capital, and Jay Dickens, and Gary Winger with Integra, and American Race Tires. Just everything we got just went really well tonight. We was late getting here, and didn't even know if we was going to come or not, but just thank the Lord we had
come on up here. Late or not, you got in here, you got rolled out, and you were fast right out of the bat.
Well, I left out Joe Denby, too. He's my main sponsor. And but, yeah, I mean, I hadn't ever been here with this car, and I hadn't raced here in over a year, and was a little uncomfortable. You know, the first hot lap session made a call to Woodstock, and, you know, Marshall helped us get dialed in, and we was able to hang on.
Well, I tell you what, it was fun to watch, and I know you worked hard out there tonight. Congratulations, and, you know, Capital Race Cars, first time here, congratulations.
Well, thank you very much, and just everybody that's a part of my program. I know I'm leaving somebody out, but Alan and Gary and, you know, everybody that helps me, and Gator. I got Gary and a Gator, but just everybody. I couldn't do it without them.
Congratulations, and we hope to see you again very soon. And good luck to your season with your series, and we hope to see you down the road some other time. And here's your championship belt. You've got one of these already, and you're going to be wearing it again. So the sixth different winner here at Volunteer, a fifth different winner. We had two times now, the repeat winner, Ray Cook, two times as we get the friend here. He's being presented with a trophy to this young fan. I want to get a word with him. Young man, tell me what your name is.
Taylor.
Taylor, where are you from?
Johnson City, Tennessee.
Yeah, that city's in a song on the radio a lot. I hear from Johnson City, Tennessee.
Uh-huh.
All right, well, how about this man here giving you that trophy and the big win with Ray Cook here tonight? I think you just made a fan for life there. Race fans, thank you for the opportunity to be here with the Carolina Class Series. Congratulations to Ray Cook for winning his second race with the Carolina Class here at the Gap.
Come over here, Billy.
Come on, Billy. Let's step back here to the second spot. A few times there we thought you might have been saving something to try to get a run on him with those final laps, but he just kind of got away from you.
Yeah, I definitely wasn't saving. I was trying to about as hard as I could, you know. I think my best chance was going to be in the lap cars, lap traffic, using the bottom down here in 3 and 4, or even 1 and 2, because some of the cars were just holding their line up top, and I feel like Ray wasn't as good when he had to go down there. But once he got back by himself and got the top, he was checking out, it looked like to me. But you know, I'm happy with second. I'm glad to come home with that. I wouldn't have thought we could have moved up that far, judging by how I started. I thought maybe a top five was going to be what I was going to get, but second's a lot better than we thought, and I would have liked to get the win, but Ray deserved the win. He earned it, and that's the way it should be.
All right, well, Billy, we got three more times up here with the Class Series, and we hope to see you with those as well. Congratulations on a good run and for that big win last week, too.
Thank you.
All right. Come on back to the third place finisher. Boy, this thing was a rocket ship during hot laps and qualifying. Opening laps kind of fell back a little bit, but come back and salvage a third place finish. Good job, Donald McIntosh, in his seventh car.
I had a great car tonight. We was a little bit off of Ray and Billy there, and I hate for Chad to fall out, but I can't thank Larry Garner, BJ Hillman, and David Bryan enough for working hard on this car. We've had some bad luck it's good to get a good run and get a finish tonight. So glad the rain held off for us, and it's awesome to be able to drive this race car.
All right, well, good luck in the rest of your endeavors, and hope to see you again back up here May the 23rd when we return to the gap.
I appreciate it. We'll be back.
All right, man. Donald McIntosh, third place finisher. Race fans, again, thank you all.